It's time for the Family Feud Battle of the Television Hosts. Introducing the Heavenly Hosts, Bert Hart, Tom Kennedy, Jim Lang, Peter Marshall, and Leslie Uggam. And now, the magnificent MC, Bill Cullen, Nipsey Russell, Bob Eubanks, Betty White, and Jim Perry. Let's start the Family Feud Battle of the Television Hosts. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Nice big hand, Heavenly Host. Right out.
Hey, Richard, how are you?
Good to have you here.
I'm glad to see you.
Here's my man here. He's going to introduce us to the panel.
Let's get everyone on. You know, they assume that because we are game show hosts, that each one of us knows the other one.
Well, we don't.
We've seen them. Now, here's a man that I've watched, admired, met him for the first time today, Tom Kennedy, one of America's best game show host.
And a great player right here.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Bert.
Also, my next friend is Jim Lang, host of Danny Game, who had the good sense to marry one of my former Miss Americas, Nancy Fleming.
Yeah. I've known her and admired her from afar.
Hello.
Good.
Magic, you know that. She's a lovely lady.
That's right.
After I tell you that Peter Marshall has won 5 Emmy Awards, besides that, is one of the most repulsive characters.
Dead out.
That's because I called an older fellow.
That's what it was. I really love Peter, and I especially love this beautiful child who's a co-host of Fantasy, Leslie Uggam.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Did a great job. Big, nice big welcome now to your rivals, headed by Uncle Bill, the magnificent MC. Mr. Bill Conrad. Hello, everybody. We've known each other many moons.
We have indeed.
May I meet all of the rest.
Speaking of many moons.
Exactly.
Fellow been around almost as many moons as I.
Ah.
He's the host of the juvenile jury.
He is indeed.
Lovely show. His name, Nipsey Russell.
Yes, sir.
The champ of all time.
He's a poet.
Poet, he is a poet.
He is a poet.
Each day we turn another page. You know you're reaching middle age when your pimples and your rashes turn to wrinkles and hot flashes.
Thank you, Nipsey.
A lot better than pimples and rashes.
Exactly, I agree with you.
We have a gentleman here who's the host of Dreamhouse, currently flourishing on another network.
But doing well.
In spite of all that.
He is on this network, Bill. It's on this network.
Who's next to Bob Eubanks?
Someone who is, although this person has won an Emmy recently, I've taught her most of the things she knows, have dangled her frequently on my knee. My good one, Betty White.
I love Betty.
And I've seen a lot of movies, too.
Exactly, many movies.
And here is a fellow who not only is a marvelous MC, but they took a poll of all the MCs, and he won it for tall, Jim Perry.
Nice big hands for all of you.
On our next show, I get to wear the blue jacket.
Okay, that'll be fine.
You ready to play?
I'm ready to play.
We will play the Feud.
All right.
Let's go. People surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here is the question. Name something that ties you down.
A rope.
I would have bet money on it. I swear to God. I would have bet money.
I love you, Bert.
Oh, Uncle Bill.
Marriage.
Marriage from Uncle Bill, the sage. Marriage?
Yeah.
You have control when you play a card.
Okay, Gary, here you be. Gary, they want to play.
Okay, that's
we
good.
We will play.
If you go back and explain rope. And
rope.
We'll find... Well done, Bill, well done. There's something that ties you down.
That ties you down. Some job.
A job.
Sure.
Job.
Yeah.
Well, it's the most wonderful part of it. It's children.
You got it.
You know.
Bob is not just another pretty face. Children! It's got to be the number one.
Well, I have to say pets.
Say it.
Pets.
Okay. I love it when you tease me.
Pets! Yeah!
You see, the last couple of days, everyone's been wearing a blue... Never mind, I don't want...
No, I saw where you were coming from.
I would say... Well, I didn't get that.
I couldn't figure out why.
That's true. I would say, in the service.
Something that ties you down?
Being in the service.
Okay, fine.
Army, Navy,
the service. The service? Oh. Although I did have an uncle who was tied down once in the... It was a nasty story.
Service and rope have been taken.
They have. It's the best thing that's happened to you in a long time.
Otherwise, I would have had it in that order. I was seeking service and looking rope. I'm going to say there's any number of things I can say. I'm stalling.
No, not at all.
A hobby.
A hobby?
Certain hobby.
Take a look. Right. Is there a hobby in the house? See, two strikes, but only one answer left, sir. Something that ties you down.
An unpleasant thought, but illness.
Illness, okay. It was there, sir. You got it all. If not, get ready to steal an illness. No, there's $86. Bert, get your heavenly host down here and give me an answer.
How about debts? Debts. Oh, they said debts already.
No, they didn't say debts.
They didn't say debts. You got debts.
Bills?
Bill's debts.
Okay. If that's there, you get the $86, and if not, Uncle Bill gets it. Bills or debts? Yeah. A boyfriend?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Although, that is illegal, I think, in several states. 86 to nothing, let's go. Come on, Lipsy. Prego.
Butane.
Long questions. So listen, 100 people surveyed, top 7 answers on the board. Here's the question. Most people are nervous when they're learning to drive. Name something else which makes people... Yes.
Getting married.
That doesn't make...
Remember I warned you it was a long question? Most people are nervous when they're learning to drive. Name something else which makes people nervous while they're learning to do it. You're not going to have about 80 people getting married all the time, Uncle Tom. What do you think it is, sir?
Makes people nervous while they're learning to do it. Skate.
Skate?
Oh,
skate!
Hey, I was real nervous on that.
No. Ooh. Jim.
Oh, learning to fly. Learning to be a pilot.
Fly? Yeah. Two answers will do it, Bob. And something else, apart from driving, it makes people nervous while they're learning to do it. Bob? Give me an answer. Player pass.
Player pass.
Play, I guess.
It's a definite. It's a definite play.
All right.
Okay. Learning a new craft, new job.
Okay. New job.
Oh, very good.
Put it there, pal. Hello, today.
Hello.
Nice to have you with us.
Thank
what would you think?
Oh, well, learning to cook is would make me nervous. You could poison somebody.
Yeah. Cook. No, first strike.
They weren't that nervous.
Bert.
Rope. No, I'm sorry. Learning to take care of small children.
Okay. Oh, yeah, I see that.
With a rope.
With a rope. Looking after small children. Not that. Well, that was a goodie. Didn't make our survey. Two strikes. Yeah, something else that makes people nervous, apart from driving.
Yeah.
Well, they're learning to do it.
Parachute jumping.
See, that's a goodie. Yeah. If that's there, you got it. If not, third strike. Parachute jumping! You got it!
Okay, made me nervous when I first learned skiing. Going down, off or anything like that.
Ski!
Oh, yeah! I have a lot of children and grandchildren, and every time I get them into the pool, they get very nervous. Swimming.
Swimming?
That's good.
Yes.
All right, if that's there, okay. If not, third strike. Swimming!
Oh, learning to play tennis?
Let's see. All right. What? Well, you can. You can miss a backhand or two, particularly if you're skiing at the same time. Tennis! Third strike, right here. Magnificent energy. Ooh, $54 right there. You want it?
Yes.
What is it?
Learning to ride a bicycle.
That's a good answer. Riding a bike?
No!
Wait a minute, Nip. What do you think it is?
I thought it was dance. You get
oh, learning to dance?
Making love.
Number two.
Sex, yes.
You don't learn that. You're born with it.
No, that's right.
Number six, please.
Dance, I say. Yeah.
Honey, if you're born with it, I'm an orphan. We'll be back right after we watch this.
Experience and mayhem of the WOF. Wheel of Fortune, weekdays, 9 a.m. Eastern, 6 a.m. Pacific, only on Game Show Network.
I'm not.
56 there, 54, let's go. People, one hand, please, Jim. 100 people surveyed, top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an item you hate to lend people because they never return it. The
lawnmower.
Yeah, it's there. Five answers will beat it.
Your car.
Bob said your car. Let's go, Grand Theft Auto. What are you going to do, player?
We're going to play. Play. Okay, come on.
All right.
An item
you hate to lend to people because they never return it, Peter.
Tools.
Got it. Tools. Yeah. Really good. What is it, Leslie?
Certain clothes. You never get them back if you lend them to your friends.
Yeah.
Clothes! Thank you. No!
Okay.
I found that in addition to rope, I hate to lend books.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think this is it.
I think you finally got one.
You want people to do shoot. Books!
I'm proud of you too.
Really? What excitement that was.
I know.
Well, when was the last time your neighbor brought back that cup of sugar? When you go over to loan them a food item.
So you hate
food items. When you loan them a food item.
Come on! What item do you lend people since they never return it, Jim?
Well, an item would be money, and that's the thing that most people don't return. Money.
And how?
Money?
Number one.
Money. Now I'm worried here. I
don't be worried.
Okay. I really can't think all of it. Right. Unless it could be.
3 seconds starting from now, you might blurt it out.
If you give someone your dog.
Your dog?
Your dog. They never give you a dog back to you.
Only because your dog is
your dog. Your dog has a room.
Your dog. You have no answer. What is it?
What about luggage?
Luggage?
Lend people luggage. You know, they're going on a trip and they never come back.
Is there? You got it? In front? Third track? Luggage? No. Magnificent MCs. Uncle Bill, what's that number four answer? What do you think it is?
The combined thinking of my group.
Yes.
Umbrella.
An umbrella?
That's all they can
do. Umbrella? Song. 131 to 86. Let's go. Come on. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a sport that seems to get more and more violent. Hockey. Good, that's good.
Very nice.
Sport that seems to get more and more violent, sir.
Football.
Football? Bam! What is it on the ball?
The way they play it now, basketball.
Basketball,
elbows,
yeah.
And umbrellas.
Many, many injuries there. Basketball? Not there. It is, true. No, just didn't make our survey. First strike.
What about boxing?
Boxing.
Boxing?
Boxing?
Yeah!
Just give me a sport.
Baseball.
Baseball?
No.
Betting. What sport?
I think maybe tennis.
Tennis.
I was going to say chess.
Pronunciation to tennis. Tennis! Tennis. No! There's enough there to make you the chance.
Okay. Right. What about soccer?
Is that it?
Yes, that's it.
Soccer, you'll play for $10,000. If not, you get the 192. Soccer? Wrestling. 278, 131. This should decide. Let's go! Okay, we've got to move along now. Wish you both luck. Dollar value's a triple. This is going to decide it. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a bad habit that has serious consequences. Yes.
Picking your nose.
What? Picking your nose? For the wolf.
Jack Nicholson, Chinatown. Picking your nose.
Smoking.
You have control. Right in your car. Don, they're gonna. How can she look so pretty and talk so dirty? I will read it once. Now, please listen, because this can decide whether you go up and play for $10,000 for your charity. I can't repeat it. When I get to you, you got 3 seconds. Name a bad habit that has serious consequences. 3 seconds, Bill.
Drinking.
Drinking. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Please stand in the next
chair. Narcotics.
Okay.
Narcotics.
Yeah. 3 seconds, Bob.
Reckless driving.
Reckless driving's there. You'll play for $10,000. Reckless driving? No. 3 seconds, Betty.
Overeating.
Again, if it's there, you're the champs. Overeating? No. 3 seconds, Jim. You can go for $10,000 if you give me number four.
What I think it is
a bad habit that has serious consequences.
Overexertion.
Overexertion.
That's it. What we call OE. And PU at the same time. Overexertion there. You play for $10,000. If not, Bill and the Magnificent MCs will. Overexertion? Exactly. Kleptomaniac is a very bad habit. Yeah. I need two people to play for $10,000. Okay, Bill? Bill Petty play for $10,000 right after we watch this.
Are you one of them?
That TV that you watched as a kid is about to pay off.
Are you ready?
There is no shame in knowing this stuff.
The new Newlywed Game, tonight at 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific.
Come on, Billy.
15 seconds, please. Name a regular member of the Tonight Show cast.
Johnny Carson.
Any day of the week.
Sunday.
Something with raisins in it.
Fruitcake.
An occupation that uses a thermometer.
Doctor.
Something pipe smokers use.
Tobacco.
Very good. Regular member of the Tonight Show, kid. It's Johnny Carson. He's about the only irregular one that was on the show, but it sounds like a goodie. Survey said. Any day of the week, except Sunday. Survey said. Yes, sir. Something with a raisin in it. Fruitcake. Something we've been called many times.
Oh, yes.
Survey said. Ken, you have 87. An occupation that uses the thermometer. Is there a doctor in the feud? Survey said. Something that pipe smokers use. Tobacco? Survey said. Well, then, here's young Bob.
All right.
There you go.
I am so nervous.
Don't be nervous, because Bill came in and got 169. You need 31 points. You get 31, you got $10,000 for your charity. Please remind us those marvelous answers Bill gave us, and then 20 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go, Chip. Name a regular member of the Tonight Show cast.
Johnny Carson.
Try again.
Ed McMahon.
Any day of the week.
Sunday.
Try again.
Saturday.
Something with raisins in it.
Bread.
An occupation that uses a thermometer.
Doctor.
Try again.
Nurse.
Something pipe smokers use.
Tobacco.
Try again.
A tamper.
The thing that... Yeah, sure. Regular member of the Tonight Show cast. Johnny, of course, was number one. You said Uncle Ed. We need 31 points. $10,000. Survey said.
He's gone to a lot of blanking trouble to look good. The least you could do is watch. Match Game, weekdays at 6:30 Eastern, 3:30 Pacific, only on Game Show Network.
$10,564. The magnificent MCs from United Negro College Fund and the Special Olympics, $12,091. We got another $10,000 to give away, and next time we all meet right here on the Feud. We love that.
Transportation for some contestant and production personnel furnished by Eastern Airlines. This holiday season, come fly away to the beautiful beaches of Florida or the Caribbean with Eastern, America's favorite way to fly. A promotional fee has been paid by introducing Glade Smoke Away, a tough new Glade, specially formulated to eliminate smoke odors instantly and make your home fresher. Spring is a P.S. Gitano, the proportionally sized jeans for the fit you love. If you're a short, regular, or long-waisted woman, P.S. Gitano's new sizing system is just for you. Rental of the Rug Doctor, improved steam carpet cleaner with vibrating brush, removes deep-down dirt from carpets. Rug Doctor, steaming mad at dirt. A seven-piece wine set and decanter from Riuniti, the best-loved, best-selling imported wine in America today. Riuniti in red, white, and rosé. There's no nicer way to break the ice. A gift certificate from trustworthy hardware stores, serving you with top-quality products and expert do-it-yourself advice. Trustworthy hardware stores.
Experience the madness and mayhem of the WOF. Wheel of Fortune, weekdays, 9 a.m. Eastern, 6 a.m. Pacific, only on Game Show Network.
Gene Woods, speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson, television production.